ओ लेवल केमिस्ट्री पेपर कोड 5070 पेपर 1 वेरिएंट 1 अक्टूबर नवंबर 16। टुडे वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 21 टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 30। क्वेश्चन नंबर 21, व्हिच रो शोज द पीएच वैल्यूज 4.1 मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ अमोनिया हाइड्रोक्लोरिक एसिड सोडियम क्लोराइड एंड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड। Here ammonia, it is alkali, hydrochloric acid is an acid, sodium chloride is a salt and sodium hydroxide is an alkali. Now pH value for a salt is 7. Now if we check the value of pH for sodium chloride, here in option C and D it is given 7. So our possible option will be C and D. Now pH value for an acid is less than 7 and pH value for an alkali is more than 7. Here it is given hydrochloric acid. So definitely the pH value for hydrochloric acid should be less than 7. Now less than 7 for pH value of hydrochloric acid is given here in option C, that is given here 1. So our correct option is option C. What about the pH values of ammonia and sodium hydroxide? Ammonia and sodium hydroxide both are alkaline in nature, so their pH value should be more than 7. Now pH value of sodium hydroxide is given 13 in option C and pH value for ammonia is given 11 in option C. So here our correct option C. Question number 22. The diagram shows the apparatus used to extract aluminum from aluminum oxide. Which statement about the process is correct? Option A. The electrolyte is a solid mixture of aluminum oxide and cryolite. Yes, it is correct. It is mixture of aluminum oxide and cryolite, but it is not solid. It is liquid mixture. So because of the word solid, this option is incorrect. Option B, the electrolyte is aluminum oxide dissolved in water. No, it is incorrect. The electrolyte aluminum oxide is in molten state. It is not dissolved in water. So option B is also incorrect. Option C, the equation for the reaction at the positive electrode is aluminum plus 3 gains 3 electron and converted to aluminum. It is correct that aluminum has plus 3 charge, it gains 3 electron and it converts to aluminum atom. But this reaction does not take place at positive electrode, this reaction takes place at negative electrode, at cathode. Here it is given the reaction is taking place at positive electrode. So this option is also incorrect. Option D, the positive carbon electrode lose mass during the process and need regular replacement. Yes, it is correct. At the positive electrode, it is carbon, it is positive electrode. At the positive electrode, at carbon electrode, oxygen gas is liberated. Now this oxygen react with carbon and it converts to carbon dioxide. So here carbon is gradually decreased that we have to replace after a certain time. So here our correct option D, the positive carbon electrode lose mass during the process and need regular replacement. Question number 23. A student has 5 reagents: dilute hydrochloric acid, dilute sulfuric acid, dilute nitric acid, solid calcium carbonate, solid copper carbonate. Here we have 3 acids and we have 2 carbonates. All these 3 acids may react with these 2 carbonates. When we react hydrochloric acid with calcium carbonate, we will get calcium chloride. When this hydrochloric acid is reacted with copper carbonate, we get copper chloride. Now both the chloride, calcium chloride and copper chloride, are soluble in water. Now we check sulfuric acid. with calcium carbonate and copper carbonate. When we react sulfuric acid with calcium carbonate, we get calcium sulfate. When we react sulfuric acid with copper carbonate, we get copper sulfate. Both calcium sulfate and copper sulfate are soluble in water. Now we check nitric acid. When we react nitric acid with calcium carbonate, we get calcium nitrate. And when we react nitric acid with copper nitrate, we get copper nitrate. Now calcium nitrate is very slightly soluble in water, or we can say it is insoluble in water, whereas copper nitrate is soluble in water. So here out of 6, 5 are soluble in water, only 1 is insoluble. So how many salts are soluble? 5 salts are soluble, that is given in option C. So correct option C. Question number 24, which reaction is not a redox reaction? Redox means where reduction and oxidation is taking place. And it is asked which reaction is not a redox. Now first we check option A. In option A we have calcium carbonate. This calcium carbonate is thermally decomposed and we get calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now in calcium carbonate, oxidation state of oxygen is minus 2. Oxidation state of calcium is plus 2. Here we have total 3 oxygen. So total negative charge will be minus 6. Here it is plus 2. To balance this one, definitely on carbon there will be plus 4. So here on calcium it is plus 2. On carbon it is plus 4. On oxygen it is minus 2 charge. After the reaction, we get calcium oxide. In calcium oxide, oxidation of calcium is plus 2. For oxygen, it is minus 2. Here we get carbon dioxide. For oxygen, oxidation state is minus 2. Here we have 2 oxygen. So total negative charge will be minus 2 multiplied by 2. It will be minus 4. So on carbon, the oxidation state, the charge will be plus 4. Now if we check the charges before the reaction and after the reaction, there is no change. Before the reaction on calcium plus 2, after the reaction on calcium plus 2, before the reaction on carbon plus 4, after the reaction on carbon plus 4, before the reaction on oxygen minus 2, and also after the reaction it is minus 2. So here we can say neither reduction nor oxidation is taking place. So our correct option A. Okay, we also check other options. In option B, it is given carbon. Here it is given oxygen. Here carbon is given in atomic state and here oxygen is given in molecular state. So here oxidation state of carbon will be 0. For oxygen, it will be 0. Here it is carbon monoxide. In carbon monoxide, for oxygen, oxidation state is minus 2. And for carbon, it is plus 2. Since here we are looking that before the reaction and after the reaction, the charge is different. One element is gaining electron and second one is losing electron. So here we have redox reaction. Same thing for the option C. Here in carbon, the oxidation state is 0. Whereas after the reaction on this carbon, the oxidation state is plus 2. In D, we have ferric oxide. In ferric oxide, oxidation state of iron is plus 3, whereas after the reaction, the oxidation state of iron is 0. So here we have redox reaction. So here in B, C and D, we have redox reaction. Only in option A, we don't have redox reaction. So our correct option A. Question number 25. Some properties which make elements differ from each other are listed. Number 1, metallic character. Number 2, number of electrons shed in an atom. Number 3, number of protons in an atom. Number 4, total number of electrons in an atom. Which two properties increase across a period of a periodic table? What is period? It is periodic table. In the periodic table, this vertical line, it is called group, and this horizontal, it is called period. Now we go back to our question. Here it is given number one, metallic character. Here metallic character, first we check metallic character, either it increase or decrease. When we move across a period, here we are looking the metallic property, the metallic character is decreasing. Here in the period, the first member lithium, it is a metal. The last member neon, it is a non-metal. So when we move across a period, the metallic property does not increase, it decreases. So here number one is incorrect. Number two, number of electron shells in an atom. When we move across a period, number of orbitals also remains same. Here we have two orbital in lithium, in beryllium again we have two orbital, in fluorine we have two orbital, in neon we have two orbital. So number of orbitals does not increase when we move across a period, it remains same. So number two is also incorrect. Number three, number of protons in an atom. Yes, it is correct. Here in lithium, the atomic number is given 3. Here in beryllium, it is 4. Then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. What is atomic number? Atomic number means number of electrons or number of protons. So here we are looking that when we move across a period, number of electrons and number of protons increases. So here it is given number of protons in an atom increase. Yes, it is correct. Number 4, total number of electrons in an atom increase. Yes, it is also correct. Both number of protons and number of electrons will be increased. Now number 3 and number 4 is given in option D. So correct option, option D. Question number 26. Aqueous copper sulfate solution is placed in an iron container and left to stand for several days. Which statement describes what happens? Atmospheric oxygen reacts with the copper sulfate to give black copper oxide. This reaction does not take place at room temperature and pressure. So this option is incorrect. Option B. Some fine iron particles are formed in the solution. If we check the reactivity series, in reactivity series, it is iron and here it is copper. Iron is more reactive than copper. So here what will happen? Here this copper sulfate will react with iron and we will get iron sulfate. And here it is given some fine iron particles are formed, so this one is also incorrect. Part C, the part of the container in contact with the solution is coated with copper. Yes, it is correct. It is discussed that iron is more reactive than copper. So iron will replace copper from copper sulfate and we will get iron sulfate. When we will get iron sulfate, along with iron sulfate, we will get pure copper. So this pure copper may be coated on the part of the container. We will get pure copper on part of the container. So here correct option, option C. What is given in the option D? The solution turns from green to blue. It is incorrect. It will change from blue to green. Copper sulfate is of blue color and here iron sulfate will be of green color. So here the color will be changed from blue to green, not from green to blue. So option D is also incorrect. Correct option, option C. Question number 27. Which equation shows a reaction that will occur at room temperature and pressure? In option A, bromine reacts with sodium chloride. In B, bromine reacts with sodium iodide. In C, iodine reacts with sodium chloride. In D, iodine reacts with sodium bromide. Here all the elements are from halogen group and also here all the compounds are halides. It is sodium chloride, sodium iodide, sodium chloride, sodium bromide. Now first we check the reactivity in halogens. It is 7A group, it is halogen group. In halogen group, when we move down the group, reactivity decreases. Since here, when we are moving down the group, reactivity decreases, so the element that is at the top that can replace all the elements from the compound that is below it. Means here, fluorine can replace chlorine. Fluorine can replace bromine. But bromine cannot replace chlorine. Or bromine cannot replace chlorine. Because bromine is less reactive than chlorine. It is less reactive than fluorine. Now in the question, here in option A it is given bromine. Here it is given sodium chloride. Now when we move down the group, first we have chlorine, then we have bromine. Means bromine is less reactive than chlorine, so bromine cannot replace chlorine. So this option incorrect. Here we have bromine and here we have iodine. We have iodine after bromine. So here we can say bromine can replace iodine. Here bromine can replace iodine. And we will get sodium bromide. So this option is correct option. What is given in the other options? Here we are looking, we have iodine. This iodine cannot replace chlorine because chlorine is more reactive than iodine. Again here iodine is reacted with sodium bromide. Bromine is more reactive than iodine. So iodine cannot replace bromine. So here correct option, option B. Bromine is more reactive than iodine, so bromine will replace iodine from sodium iodide and we will get sodium bromide. Question number 28. Attaching pieces of magnesium to underground iron pipes can protect the iron from corrosion. Which reaction protects iron from corrosion? Here this topic is related to sacrificial metal. Sacrificial metal means if we have two metals, the more reactive metal will be oxidized first. Now here we have magnesium and we have iron pipes. We have to check whether magnesium is more reactive or iron is more reactive. It is reactivity series. It is magnesium and we have here iron. Magnesium is more reactive than iron. So magnesium will be oxidized first, then iron. So if we have iron and with the iron we have attached magnesium, so first this magnesium will be oxidized and our iron pipe will remain safe. Now we check the options. Option A, ferrous ion gains 2 electrons and converted to iron. In option B it is given iron loses 2 electrons and converted to ferrous ion. It is discussed here that magnesium is more reactive than iron. So magnesium will corrode first, not iron. So iron will not take part in the reaction. So option A and B are incorrect. Option C, magnesium ion gains 2 electrons and converted to magnesium. And here in D it is given magnesium loses 2 electrons and converted to magnesium ion. Corrosion is an oxidation reaction. Oxidation means loss of electron. So here our correct option will be option D because here magnesium is losing 2 electrons. Whereas in C, this magnesium ion is gaining 2 electrons. It is not oxidation, it is reduction. So option C is incorrect. Our correct option, option D. Question number 29. Which compound is used as a fertilizer? Ammonium sulfate, barium carbonate, calcium hydroxide, lead chloride. Ammonium sulfate, it is used as a fertilizer. So our correct option, option A. Question number 30. In the Haber process, hydrogen and nitrogen react to form ammonia in the presence of a catalyst. Which of the two reactants is obtained by fractional distillation and what is the catalyst used in the Haber process? In Haber process, we prepare ammonia by reacting hydrogen and nitrogen. This nitrogen we get from air by fractional distillation, and during this reaction, as a catalyst, we use iron. Now, for the catalyst, we use iron, that is given in A and in C. And by fractional distillation, we get nitrogen, that is given here in option C. So, correct option, option C. We get nitrogen by fractional distillation, and in this reaction, we use iron as a catalyst. So, correct option, option C. Okay, we have completed up to question number 30. The remaining part from 31 to 40 we will solve in the next session.